is up there, just keep pouring on me. I have no idea what I was gonna say there. Would you please fix my bangs? Oh dear. Oh, that was an accident.
Are you sure?
Oh, yep, sure. Hi. Happy Saturday from your friendly Valentine's Cupid. Just your old neighborhood locked up, staring at the world outside her window. Cupid with arrows that I want to shoot at people. Out of love, of course. So I've been in rehab for 1 week, not for drugs, for physical rehab. If you didn't know already, I've been paralyzed for like 6 months. So anyways, I know I've given updates so far. I'll give a few more updates. Then I'll talk about my viewpoint on things that are embarrassing. I'll also let you know what happened to my belly button and my relationship with my therapist so far. So yeah, update. I'm still getting stronger in therapy. I haven't gone backwards all day at all. Although I live like in paranoia. Like my face will twitch and I'm like, I'm going down. Like it's comeback. Everything's over. And then it's just like it's an itch or something. But things went good so far. It's still just my right arm and my left leg that are getting strong. My right leg and my left arm still just like to do a lot of this, like this. But my right arm likes to do this. And my left arm likes to do this. Ow! Okay. And then my left leg likes to go like this. And like this. And sometimes I like to sit like this. When I'm feeling like casual. But my right leg likes to do this. It can go side to side, but I can't kick. So I've just been practicing on standing on my left leg and stuff like that. Things have been going good here. Every once in a while I get left on the toilet. You know, someone puts me in there and asks if I want a minute, and I say sure, and then I sit there for, my record is 30 minutes. Not here, but that's the longest I was left on a toilet, forgot about. But my goal is to be able to stand up off the toilet by myself, like a big girl. The therapist, they've been great. I feel bad for the therapist sometimes because they can't win with me. Like, if they're like, okay, can you do this? And I'm like, yes. Like, I can do this. My God. Or they're like, oh, can you sit up without falling backwards? I'm like, yes. And then they're like, okay, kick with your right leg. And I'm like, are you kidding me? I can't kick with my right leg. Like, of course I can kick with my right leg. You're asking so much of me. So it's like they can't win. I'm either like, my ego's like, I got this. Or I'm like, you're insane. You just asked me to do the hardest thing ever. But, yeah. Therapy's going good. For a while, my body was pretty crazy. I mean, it still is, but I was watching my body fall apart, and I would look down and be like, I feel like I'm not even looking at my own body because all the muscles have gotten so, like I joke, I weigh about 114 pounds now, and it's like 114 pounds of flaccid muscle is what I tell people. I got all this flaccid muscle for you. But the weirdest thing that's happened to my body that I just really couldn't get past is my belly button. It all of a sudden I looked down one day and I was in the shower and it was pointing the wrong direction. It was pointing to the right. And it was off center. And I don't know if it was the way I'm sitting or like what it was, but I couldn't get over that my belly button was moving around. I'm happy to report that, don't worry, my belly button's gone back to center, and that is a huge achievement for me. So I've been doing crunches and bathroom hose. Even the left side of my stomach was bigger than the right side for a little while. Riddle me that. Yeah, I know.
Yeah.
That was an accident. We're filming. Yeah, I was talking to somebody the other day and she was really sweet and she's like, watching you, she said, I've become more at peace with her struggles that she's going through. And she said, I've just been too embarrassed to tell people about what I have going on. She had another autoimmune. She's like, I've just been embarrassed. And then it's funny because like it never occurred to me that I should be embarrassed. Like, I post the ugliest shit on Facebook. And I say the most, like, I guess it's embarrassing stuff. I mean, I had a sideways belly button and all the other things I've said in here, like, but it just never occurred to me that I should be embarrassed because I feel like I know that this is not forever. Like, I don't identify who I am by what's going on. Like, in the past, like I know I'm capable of being, like, hot. Like, I've lived some nights in my time where I got ready and I said, yeah, I'm hot tonight. You just clicked the nursing button. But there's been some nights where I'm like, I look hot, I look good. And I know I'll have nights like that again. And I know whatever struggles I'm going through right now, I'll be able to heal. And I hope that this vitiligo autoimmune that I have on my skin with all these white spots on my leg, of course I hope it goes away. But if it doesn't, it's just part of my character. And I'm truly a little animal, a little leopard. But, like, I didn't mean for this to happen. I don't have any bad intentions. Like, I wasn't like, I'm gonna get sick so that I can just mess with people and do bad things. Like, it just happened. I don't still have anything to be ashamed of or be embarrassed about. And everyone has, that's been something cool, I feel like, of this experience. Like, that the good part of it has been I've had so many people reach out and say that, like, see me go through this and not lose my shit. Well, I guess some people would think I lost my shit, but judging by that, I'm dressed up in a red wig with hearts growing out of my head. But like, wow, it's really gotten to her. But it's been neat that everybody had said, like, my situation has made them feel more comfortable about their situation. And let me tell you, like, everyone has something they're going through. Everybody. Like, you shouldn't be embarrassed because something bad happened to you. Like, I mean, I hope you guys still like me, even though you found out I'm not perfect. Surprise! I'm not a perfect specimen. Like, maybe I had everyone fooled. But none of us are. And it's okay to be vulnerable. I feel like I've had a lot of good support around me because I have been vulnerable. And if you have something going on, then maybe it's okay for you to be vulnerable too and let people help you. And anyways, that's my thoughts on that. But maybe I'm also just saying all this so that I don't feel embarrassed by all the ugly shit I've said. So I have to go with this, right? But yeah, we're all going through stuff, and there's things that y'all are going through that some of you have told me, and like, I couldn't do it what you're doing. Like, may not have anything to do with health, just a personal struggle or like an emotional thing or something with your parents or. Some, like, you're in constant pain all day. At least I'm in constant pain. Like, it's okay to, you're fine. I guess I'm just saying you're fine with whatever shit that's wrong with you. It makes you makes you just as perfect as everybody else. So never be embarrassed or ashamed. Just own it and put on a wig and be happy. I did want to share with you guys. I'm going to be on the Channel 8 News. That's the Dallas-Fort Worth news station at 10 p.m. on Monday. So if you're around and want to see the news story they did on me, it's Monday night, 10 o'clock, Channel 8, which is WFAA or ABC. You can live stream it online to 10 o'clock Central Time. So if you want, the really, really nice news lady who I love, she's going to come back to my house and I'm going to interview her. She said she would let me. And I told her I want to take her to a wine bar. She's awesome. But so that's that. What's next for me is Friday. I'll be here at least Friday at the rehab hospital. And then I'm going to try to get discharged into some kind of assisted living or skilled nursing facility. But my insurance said they might not approve it. So I just have to roll with the punches, and I really mean roll because that's all I can do. So I'll just stick with that. Anyways, thanks for all the nice messages and all of the wonderful things you guys are all doing for me. Really, like, it makes my day and it makes all everyday fun. And I'm just really happy with who I have around me. And I'm sorry if I don't respond to things all the way right away, but some people would want to reach out to my sister or like my ex-boyfriend or stuff. You can reach out to me directly on Facebook Messenger. I can, now that my voice is better, I'm a lot better about responding and everything. So yeah. And David and I aren't really, we don't talk really much, so if you have any questions, you can just ask me directly. I think that's it. I hope that you get lots of sugars poured on you for Valentine's Day. And I hope that you feel loved on Valentine's Day. And if you don't have anybody, then just love yourself times two. Somebody asked me, they said, how do you know if you love yourself? And I didn't really know how to answer that question. If you do, then comment below, because I got a little stumped on that. But yeah, and good luck with whatever struggles you're going through. It just makes you unique. Love you. Happy Valentine's Day. Goodbye.